Now, to receive these callbacks, we first go back to the physics engine class and add a nice wrapper function that allows us to set some of our callback functions for Box2D. In general, Box2D allows you to get callbacks during multiple phases of collision. We have a begin contact, which occurs when things are touching, but the collision calculation hasn't done yet, end contact, when the contact analysis is over, and post solve, which is called once the physics collisions have occurred. For our purposes, we need to find a new function in the physics engine that allows the engine to pass in custom callbacks to be executed when any one of these phases occurs. This code is fairly simple, although deep. We take in an object that contains callbacks we're looking for and define logic that will issue a callback to those functions once the engine hits that phase. So for instance, we assume that if the callbacks.postSolve method exists, then we define the postSolve method on our listener as a function that takes in the contact and impulse passed from Box2D, and we'll actually send that to the postSolve function in our contact, giving it the two bodies for the fixtures that are touching. Now Box2D operates in a different environment than we do. That is, that it operates in fixtures that are colliding, and we have to go then fetch the body object that we're using. Once we've set all of our callback handlers that we want, we actually can call world.setContactListener and pass in the listener object. This will effectively bake in all of our contact objects into the world so that anytime we get these collision objects, we'll get collision callbacks.